We have y double prime plus lambda y is equal to 0. We're told that y prime of 0 is 0, and y prime of pi is also 0. We're going to make the assumption that lambda is a real number. And only for the purpose of making it convenient in the problem, we're going to let lambda be some number we call alpha squared. That does not necessarily mean that lambda is a perfect square. We had a case where lambda equaled 3, and so alpha ended up equaling the square root of 3. But just for convenience and because it looks easier in the characteristic equation, so we don't get a radical, we're going to call it alpha squared. So our equation becomes then y double prime plus alpha squared y equals 0. That means our characteristic equation is r squared plus alpha squared. And so r will equal plus or minus alpha times I. So that was just like before when we had lambda equal to 4. Then here alpha came out to be 2, plus or minus 2. So what would our solutions look like? What would a combination of sine and cosine? So we would have a cosine alpha x plus b sine alpha x. Everybody clear on where this comes from? So let's look at our conditions. We have to take the derivative because both of our conditions are based on the derivatives. So our first derivative, we're going to get negative a sine a alpha sine alpha x. Plus b alpha cosine alpha x. And if we let y prime equal 0, we're going to get negative a alpha times the sine of 0. We know that's going to go to 0. Plus b alpha cosine of 0. So we know that one's gone. This will be b times alpha equals 0. And let's assume that alpha is not 0. Well, let's don't assume that. Let's see what happens if alpha is 0. Hold on. This means either b is 0 or alpha is 0. So let's look at both cases. If B equals 0, then Y equals 0, and that would just be a trivial solution. So that's not useful. If alpha equals 0, then remember lambda was alpha squared, so that would make lambda equal to 0. So lambda equals 0, in this case, would be considered an eigenvalue. Is there a function associated with that? So our differential equation would become y double prime plus 0y equals 0, or y double prime equals 0. Can I solve that? Yeah, how do we solve that? Just integrate. What do you get if you integrate 0? You get a constant. All right, integrate again. What do you get? Okay. Is that all? Plus another constant, right? So this would become our eigenfunction. If you can plug in an eigenvalue and solve your differential equation, not value, then you get an eigenfunction. So the proper value for lambda in that case was lambda equals 0. That's your eigenvalue. And that yielded a solution of C1x plus C2, and we call that solution our eigenfunction. Now, if we look at that first derivative, what did we say the first derivative had to equal?
Zero.
What was our first derivative? It was 0. So if this was just C1, then C1 would have to take on the value of 0 at 0. In that case, then, this eigenfunction would simplify to y equals c2. And so this eigenfunction, really, you just scale it. And you would say instead of c2, you just call it y equals 1. And that's only because C2 is an arbitrary constant, and 1 is the simplest arbitrary constant. So if you get a constant, you call the eigenfunction 1, because you can scale that to anything you want to. Now, let's look at the other condition we were given. What's the other condition we were given? At pi. If we look at that equal to 0, remember that our first derivative was negative A alpha sine alpha x plus B alpha cosine alpha x. So if we put in pi, we're going to get negative a alpha sine pi alpha. Plus B alpha cosine pi alpha. We established from the other condition that B was zero. Back over here. Let me find it.
Either we had B equals zero or alpha equals zero from over here. So we've already talked about B.
So let's look back over here. So this is just going to be then negative A alpha sine pi alpha. Equal to zero. That means either A is zero, and that's trivial. So that doesn't get us anywhere. Or alpha equals zero. We've already dealt with that. Or the only other possibility would be for sine pi alpha to be zero. And so either sine pi alpha will be zero if pi alpha is equal to n times pi, right? Where n is an integer. So alpha equals n. So that means your eigenvalue will be lambda equals alpha squared, or n squared, and then your eigenfunction goes back to y equals a cosine alpha. So our alpha was n. And again, you simplify it just to a coefficient of 1. So this is your eigenfunction associated with this eigenvalue. So here's the summary. Our original equation was y double prime plus lambda y equals zero. Our initial conditions were y prime of zero equals zero, and then y prime of pi equals zero. the proper values we could put in for alpha. Where 0 and n. So that gave us, for our values of lambda, 0 or n squared. These values of lambda we called our what?
Eigenvalues.
And then our solutions when we had a 0, we simplified to y equals 1.
It was y equals an arbitrary constant, but you just scale it down to 1.
Our other one was y equals cosine of nx. And what did we call those solutions? Those were our eigenfunctions.
So on the test, you would list your eigenvalues and your eigenfunctions that you have found. Any questions about that problem we just did before we do another one? Just dive into the other one. Let's do the other. Number 4. They did say in the directions, first determine whether lambda equals 0 is an eigenvalue. So what did we decide about that in problem 2? It was. Okay. Look at number 4.